Welcome to Skyvia Tutorials. In this video, we'll show you how to integrate Acumatica with SQL Server. Skyvia can fully integrate Acumatica with cloud apps, databases, or data warehouses like MySQL, PostgreSQL, or Snowflake with no code. In this video, we will cover two scenarios: replication of Acumatica data to SQL Server using the ELT approach, and sync data from SQL Server to Acumatica using reverse ETL. This tutorial assumes you already have a Skyvia account. If you don't have one, you can create it for free by following the link in the description. Let's start by creating connections to Acumatica and SQL Server. To connect to Acumatica, click Create New and select Connection. Look for Acumatica in the list. Sign in with your Acumatica credentials and save the connection. Now let's connect to SQL Server. Click Create New, Connection. Skyvia supports connections with databases and data warehouses such as MySQL, PostgreSQL, Snowflake, Azure, BigQuery, Redshift, and more. There are two ways of creating a connection to SQL Server. Direct, enter the agent. Use a direct connection if your SQL Server is accessible through the internet. To connect to SQL Server, specify server host, username, password, and database. If your SQL Server is not accessible via the internet, use agent connection. In this setup, Skyvia connects to the server through the agent application, which acts as a secure layer between Skyvia and your database server. To create a connection through agent, first download the agent app by clicking Create New Agent. Follow the instructions to install it on your computer and name your agent for easy identification. Once the agent app is installed, launch it and make sure it is connected. Then proceed to create connection to SQL Server. Select the agent connection mode and choose your agent from the list. Enter the server's IP address, your user ID, password, and the database to connect to. Once the connections are ready, let's move to our first case, data replication of Acumatica invoices to SQL Server. Most often it is used as a data source for analytics with BI tools like Power BI and Tableau. To replicate Acumatica data, click Create New and choose Replication. Select Acumatica as a source and SQL Server as a target. On the right, you see the list of Acumatica objects. Skyvia will create a copy of the selected objects and keep them up to date in target. Skyvia provides access to Acumatica account, activity, bill, case, customer, invoice, vendor, and more. For this example, we select invoice and customer objects. To adjust the replication settings for the selected object, click the Edit button. All fields will be replicated by default. You can manually select fields for replication and apply custom filters. Select replication modes. Standard applies the integration level behavior with incremental updates. Resync forces the full replication by dropping and creating a table in target during each replication run. Resync on demand is used for objects that are part of your replication but are not required for each run. With this option, you can include the object in the next replication run by resetting its last sync time. Use history mode to track the history of the entries in your database. Enable it for the object in Acumatica to store every change made to the object's rows in SQL Server. If you enable history mode, Skyvia replaced the update operation with insert and add three more columns to the table in SQL Server: history start, history end, and active value. Use these columns to analyze data for the specific date or time. You can define how to represent complex structured data during replication. The default option applies integration-wide settings, but you can also specify settings for each field individually. Select Table to store nested objects as rows in a separate table, or choose JSON to store them as values within a column. Skyvia supports hashing sensitive information when loading data to a database. To hash a field, select Hashed. Once done, click Save Task. Let's check integration-wide replication options. Enable incremental updates to include only changes applied to data since the last replication run. When it's enabled, tables will be created only during the first replication run. Select the Update Schema checkbox to apply data structure changes made in Acumatica to the schema in SQL Server. Also, you can choose to create or drop tables. Finally, Choose the default behavior for representing fields with complex structured data. Select JSON Collins to replicate nested objects and arrays as columns with JSON data, or choose separate tables to replicate these fields into additional tables. It's all set, and we can run the replication manually or schedule it. You can set the schedule to start replication every day or on specific weekdays, every few hours or minutes. This way, you can achieve near real-time data integration. We schedule it to run every Monday at 10 a.m. Validate the replication to ensure all connections are available and set up properly. Once done, click Create. Let's run the replication and check the results. On the Monitor tab, you see the number of replicated rows, and if some rows fail to replicate, you will receive an error log. Additionally, you can set up email notifications in case the integration fails. Let's move to a reverse ETL scenario. Skyvia Import is a wizard-based ETL tool that allows you to sync data between SQL Server and Acumatica in any direction. We will import vendors list from SQL Server to Acumatica, ensuring up-to-date data for operational processes such as procurement, inventory, and financial reporting. Let's set up the integration. Click Create New and choose Import. Select the data source type. Select the SQL Server as a source and Acumatica as a target. Let's define the source and the target object and map their columns. To do this, we create an import task. Select a vendor object. Use the filter option to select the rows you want to import. For example, we select only the records created last week. Next, specify the target object in Acumatica. Choose one of the operations to perform. Insert adds new data and update changes the values in existing data. Upsert adds new records while updating existing ones. And delete will help you mass delete data from Acumatica. We continue with the upsert operation. Now map the columns. On the right, you see all the columns of the Acumatica vendors. Columns marked with a required symbol must be filled to create or update a record in Acumatica. Skyvia will automatically map columns with matching names. For those with different names, you can manually adjust the mapping. You can map to the column, set the constant value, use functions and operators in the expression, or select lookup to obtain a value from a different source or target object. Once it is done, save the task. If you need to import multiple objects, you can add several tasks. Let's set up the schedule to run import automatically. Now, let's create the integration and we're ready to run it. That's it. We imported vendors from SQL Server to Acumatica. All the rows were imported successfully and the Acumatica data was updated. For complex scenarios, Skyvia offers data flow and control flow. These tools allow building ETL pipelines for advanced transformations with custom logic across multiple sources and include runtime error handling. For instance, this data flow selects invoices from SQL Server. Then it adds a custom field based on other SQL Server fields and imports the resulting data to Acumatica. You can learn more about a data flow component on our YouTube channel. In this tutorial, you learn how to integrate Acumatica with SQL Server using Skyvia. Try Skyvia for free by following the link in the description. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to leave a comment. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next videos.